four for me is what I think the wild card will look like. And, well, we have 14 teams this time around. You know, so surely we could get some upsets, you know. With only one seed, you know, only the number one seed getting a bye. There's two teams, you know, one from each conference that has a bye. And now we have three games each day, six games in total. So we start out with a very, very interesting game. Yeah, that the Bills are taking on the Colts. Honestly, you know, if we were in a 12-team playoff system like we should be, I don't think the Colts would have been able to get in. Mostly because I just don't think the Colts were consistent enough, you know? I don't think they were consistent enough to get playoff consideration, but here they are. They are in the playoffs. And they're going to take on the red-hot Bills. Josh Allen, Stephon Diggs. I mean, the Bills have been lighting up the scoreboard. Now, granted, only one of those games was actually, you know, Bills taking on a legitimate contender. But, you know, still, the Bills have been lights out this year. You know, for the most part, they've been racking up wins. They've been getting things done on both sides of the ball. And Phillip Rivers, you know, if he throws an interception or two, I think it'll be, you know, a long day. But if they can give the ball to Jonathan Taylor, though, I think the Colts will be fine. I do think the Bills will advance, though, to the next round. Yes, that's right. You're hearing predictions from little old me. Usually doesn't happen. But the Bills, I think, will advance on to the next round. They will probably host another playoff game. Also, on that day, Rams-Seahawks Part 3. Now, a couple weeks back, the Seahawks suffocated the Rams. What are the Rams going to look like this week? You know, we'll find out, because I'm not sure what's going on out there in LA. If Goff is coming back and starting, you know, and things like that, you know, and the Seahawks, you know, they have turned it around somehow. They're back, you know, getting a home playoff game and everything like that. And yet, the Rams can take it to them. The Rams can beat them. You know, the Rams do have enough pieces in order to win this game against the Seahawks on the road. But they gotta get the pressure on Russell Wilson. They gotta get Aaron Donald going. They gotta get him on them. If that doesn't happen, you know, we start seeing the Russell Wilson of September again. You know, flashing. Flashing it up, lighting up the field in the playoffs. Oh boy, gonna be a long day. But it's kind of a toss up here, you know, for this game. But if I were to go with a winner, it would be maybe the Rams. I mean, I'm not gonna be completely wrong here. You know, it could be the Rams. But I mean, again, the NFC is always loaded. You know, not as much this year as it has been in the past, but I think, you know, it could be either or. We could get, you know, the Seahawks that looked like trash, that looked awful, looked like they had no offensive line, looked like they had no defense. Or we could get the Rams that look completely anemic. I mean, we don't know which team we'll get. Whoever wins this game is going to be either going somewhere, you know, going on the road again next week, or hosting another playoff game. You never know. And last, on Saturday night, we have the Bucks taking on the Washington football team. And the football team gets to host the playoff game at 7-9. Alex Smith on offense, comeback player of the year, probably. Chase Young, defensive rookie of the year, probably. Don't sleep on this Washington defense. You know, they can do a lot of things. They can. They have gotten mighty hot over the past month and a half or so. But the Bucks, they are finally getting, they finally got it all together, and they got Tom Brady, you know, doing, you know, Tom Brady things. It wasn't 2019 New England out there, Tom Brady. It's 2020 Tom Brady with the Bucks of Tampa Bay. And Bucks will advance, though. Now, here's a toss-up. Sunday. What happened last year with these two teams, you know, was a thing of beauty. Derrick Henry's stiff arm that was heard around the world. And the Titans get to host the playoff game against the Ravens this time around. And, you know, it's going to be one interesting time. It's going to be one interesting time, you know, for these two teams. Ravens are getting hot at the right time. They are definitely getting hot at the right time. But I think the key is going to be what the Titans are going to do on defense. You know, they've looked kind of rough these last 2 weeks. And there have been times this year where the Titans will just get completely outmatched on defense. Remember when they got blown up by the Colts? You know, back on Thursday night a couple months ago. Just completely outmatched in that game. They got outmatched against the Packers. They just completely got blown out. Texans, they let them come back. This cannot happen again. If you want to keep going, if you want to get through that grind of the postseason, you gotta get it done on defense. You can't just have Derrick Henry run the ball, bail you out. Conversely, for the Ravens, you can't just have Lamar and the stable of backs in the backfield run it out. Lamar has to throw against this Titans defense. He has to get Hollywood Brown open. He has to get him open. But yeah, this game's a toss-up. You know, either or. I'm thinking too, like the Rams Seahawks game. You know, but here's a team that doesn't deserve to be in the playoffs at all, and that is the Chicago Bears. Definitely does not deserve to be in the playoffs. At 8-8. They somehow stumbled into a playoff position. I'm not even gonna entertain the idea of talking about this game. I think the Saints, you know, will handle business. Of course, there is COVID issues with the Saints. You know, running back core Alvin Kamara's been out. I don't know how in the world things are gonna work this week. But if the Saints get going passing, and you know Drew Brees starts passing that ball, oh boy. Hoo-wee boy. I think the Bears will be toast. I don't know. That offensive line of the Saints is pretty good. So, you know, Khalil Mack can't really just get around there, you know, to sack Drew Brees like that. So, meanwhile, last but not least in the wild card round is the Browns and the Steelers. The Browns, again, are dealing with COVID issues. Steelers, they had, you know, one of the worst Decembers I've ever seen in my entire life. They looked rough out there on the field, and yet somehow they stumbled their way into a playoff game. I mean, they've lost, what, 4 of their last 5 games now, and the Browns are looking pretty nice. But the Browns have to get everything going, you know, apart from COVID, tearing this team apart and having coaches, you know, coach from remote locations and players missing out. The Browns got to get some offense going. They, at times this year, not gotten the offense they needed. You know, Baker Mayfield needs to get that rock thrown. He needs to throw the rock. You know, you can't rely on Chubb and Hunt all the time. You gotta get that rock thrown, and you gotta penetrate the core of the Steelers defense. You know, because the Steelers defense is still, they're still tough. You can't count them out. For the Steelers, it's been the same storyline as it's been the past month. Keep the ball in your hands when you catch it. You know, do not throw the ball 50 times a game. Do not throw the ball 50 times a game, Ben Roethlisberger. Do not throw the ball 50 times a game. If you throw the ball 50 times a game, that is a recipe for disaster. This isn't the air raid, son. You can't do that. This is the NFL. So, again, this one's also a toss-up. Like, I can see either of these teams winning. But, you know, the only ones I'm really sure about is Bears-Saints and maybe Colts-Bills, maybe Bucks-Washington too. But the other three games, complete toss-ups, you know, for the wild card. And so Super Wild Card, you know, the Super Wild Card Saturday, Super Wild Card Sunday, gonna be one hell of a time. So I will see you all tomorrow. Yes, I know, tomorrow